Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and you may be wondering why it is that I'm wearing this thing on my head. Well, it's not because I'm getting a degree today, but instead we are going to give polynomials degrees today. That's right, today we are going to learn how to give a polynomial a degree. But first, we need to be able to find the degree of a term. And if you're not sure how to do that, check out the link provided. In order to find the degree of a polynomial, we first need to find the degree of each of the terms in that polynomial. And whichever term has the highest degree will be the degree of that polynomial. Let's consider five different examples, starting with this one. If each term in a polynomial only has one variable, we look for the variable that has the highest exponent. Whatever the value of that exponent is the degree of the polynomial. In this next example, we have two different variables, x and y. But not to worry though. To get the degree of each term, we simply add the exponents of x and y. And remember that a constant term has a degree of zero. So in this polynomial, the second term has the highest degree of 13, and that is going to be the degree of this polynomial. In this example, the degree of term 1 is 3, and the degree of term 2 is also 3. But the degree of term 3 is 1 plus 3, which gives us 4. And since this term has the highest degree, we could say that the degree of the polynomial is 4. Next, we may be tempted to conclude that the degree of this polynomial is 3, because the degree of the first term is 3, and the degree of the second term is also 3. And the third term doesn't look like much until we add the values of the exponents of each of the variables. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 gives us 4, and so actually the degree of the third term is the highest degree, which means that the degree of this polynomial is 4. Finally, in this last example, we notice that the degree of term 1 is 3, the degree of term 2 is 3, and the degree of term 3 is also 3. Threes all around. That's not a problem. We can still conclude that the degree of this polynomial is 3. I hope that you now feel more confident in finding the degree of any polynomial. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.